Hey guys, there we go.
Fixed it.
Yeah.
Fixed it.
All right. Let's see who's all in here.
I'm about 5 minutes late. Four minutes.
A couple minutes late.
We're gonna jump right into it here in about.
Hello, Sue. Welcome
one
in.
1 to 2 minutes today, guys. We have an ESP. So what you'll need, either a dumbbell if you have it, again at home, a milk jug, anything with a handle that you could possibly hold.
Two weights.
So two milk jugs, two waters, two whatever you got two of. That's similar in weight.
Yep.
All right. I think we're good.
Yeah. Good morning. Sorry we're tardy. We were having issues, but it's good to see you guys. All right. So we're gonna start. Well, first. Make sure you got those heart rate monitors working. If you guys do not have a heart rate monitor at home, you're having issues with yours, let us know. We are running a sale on all heart rate monitors right now, $20 off. So let us know if you want more information about that. But let's get you started on your heart rate monitors and let's roll right into that warm up.
All right. We have a 3 minute warm up. We're gonna go two rounds through. So we're gonna start with a side to side toe tap, so we're gonna be down low into a squat. We're tapping, bringing one foot in next to the other, side to side. We're gonna be 20 total. Again, sink low, keep that chest nice and high. You're firing up those legs.
Yeah. It's going to be your squat to your overhead reach. We're sitting down and back into our heels. Arms come up overhead. Exhale, press your feet through the floor. We're working 10 reps here. Option would be your reduced range of motion.
Internally with that leg. So again, once you hit five, we're just gonna rotate that direction, rotating internally towards your body. And then switch up those legs. All those joints pop in this
I know.
Morning. Getting old.
Crackling. So if you're just joining us now, we're working through our first round on our warm-up. We'll work another round back through for you. Right, that last movement, your jump jack, feet start underneath your hips. We're gonna hop wide, arms come up and over. We're back down. We go 10 reps on the jump jack. All right, guys, we're back at the top. It's your side to side toe tap.
Get down low as you can. Keep that chest lifted.
Final two.
Woo. That squat overhead reach. Feet underneath those hips. Sink down low. Lift those arms up right above the head. We have 10 total.
Standing hip rotation. We're driving the knee up, back, and around. We'll go five in each direction. Oh, I skipped the lateral lunge, didn't I? That's okay. So we made it through five on each direction. Swap out. You're popping too.
I'm popping.
And that final movement, your jump jack.
We'll do 20 total.
All right. All right.
Whew. All right, that is our warmed up. We are warmed up. Total body ESP, so your first block, guys, is gonna be 8 minutes long. We are gonna see four different movements. We're gonna work the first two movements for two rounds, the second two movements for two rounds, and then we'll tell you what we need to repeat until time is called. So we're gonna start it off with your single leg deadlift. So again, grab that weight. You can do this for body weight as well. So start with body weight if you don't have anything. It's 1 foot, planted on the ground. We're gonna have that chest nice and proud as you go down. Really keeping that weight close to your body, that chest, that spine, all staying one straight line, right to about mid-shin, come right up, squeeze the glutes. So all that pressure is in that one leg that's planted. Your option here, you can reduce that range of motion. If you have a stair, a table, a chair, you can go ahead and reduce that range of motion, tap those fingertips to that elevated level, come right back up. We're gonna go eight on each leg, on the right, on the left, then we'll take it into your jump lunge. Big step back, we have eight total reps. So again, alternate those feet at the top, find your balance. Option here, lose the jump completely. It's a reverse lunge, back and forth, alternating those legs. So we're gonna do those first two for two rounds. Woo! Ready?
Yeah.
All right, let's get right into it.
All right.
We'll show you the next two movements after we go through these ones.
Let's
go. One, two, three, here we go, guys. So again, eight total on each leg for that deadlift. A lot of balance and stability through this movement. So again, without a weight, if you need to, that elevated surface. You should feel that slight pull in your hamstring, your glute on the way down. Once you hit eight, switch up those legs. Ooh.
There we go. So keeping shoulders away from your ears.
Embrace that core also on the way down. That'll help protect that lower back, especially if you do have a weight, anything in hand. Last couple reps right here.
Whew. Once you've made it through your eight reps, we're into those eight total alternating jump lunge. So again, power focused on this one.
On each side, switch up those legs.
Thinking about breathing in as you're lowering towards the floor. Exhale as you're pressing through the floor, driving evenly through your midfoot and heel. If you're needing a little bit more balance, focus on one focal point on the floor about 3 feet out in front of you. It's gonna give you a little bit more stability. Two rounds through these next two movements. It's gonna be your palms to elbows. So we set ourselves up. Our feet are about hip width apart, and my elbow is going to replace my palm. Elbow replaces the palm, and then we're walking it back up to the top. You can lead 4 times on your right hand side, 4 times on your left, drop to your knees. We're going 8 in total. Then we have 40 total on your running man. Same high plank position, shoulders over wrists, drawing knee to your chest. Make it a controlled effort here, working those quick feet. If you do need to, palms go into an elevated surface. 2 rounds through those two movements.
Woo! All right, here we go. 8 total, 4 on each arm for these palms to elbows. When you come up from there, again, 40 running man.
Woo-wee. Woo. Once you've made it through all 40, take a second, shake out your shoulders. We're back in, your plank, palm to elbow.
A wider base also with your feet will help stabilize that core.
Shoulder burn.
Those 40 running man's from here. Alright guys, about 2 minutes left. So what we're gonna do to finish this block off, those 8 jump lunges, 40 running mans, repeating those until time is called. So again, just a little under 2 minutes we'll be working those. So again, jump lunges, stagger that stance, find that explosive jump at the top, switching those feet.
Shoulders over wrists, eyes going directly to the floor, shoulders away from your ears.
Over 1 more minute. At least getting 1 more good round in. Be a cardio section.
I know.
Woo!
I think I did 5.
I just followed you.
Sorry.
I lost count again.
S- breath for about 90 seconds. And then we're gonna take it into a cardio focus block. It's gonna be 5 minutes long. Whew. You got some time, catch your breath. Give us a wave if you're feeling good. Good morning, Will, Sarah, hello, welcome. Angela, hello.
Good morning.
I don't want to touch it. Yesterday I dropped you guys.
I don't want to drop you guys.
No.
All right, so your 5 minute cardio session will be five rounds. 30 seconds of work, 30 seconds off. You're doing anything that you can just to get that heart rate up. So if you have a set of stairs right next to you, go up and down those stairs for 30 seconds. We'll rest for 30. You can do jumping jacks, jump lunges, anything to elevate that heart rate. Working hard for 30, off for 30. Again, it'll be five rounds, 5 minutes.
Woo! You about ready?
About 30 more seconds, Coach, to breathe.
Sorry.
She's ready.
I know, I was ready. I was excited.
I mean, we can go early.
Are you guys ready? I'm ready. All right.
What do you want to do first?
I like side to side.
Side to side. We're going to go lateral. So we're going to be down low in a squat. We're going to go lateral side to side for 30 seconds.
Crew, we're hitting it in 3, 2, 1.
You okay?
Yep. Over halfway, final 10 seconds. Resting for 30 in 3, 2, 1, let's rest. Woo. So you can continue doing that same thing you just did or switching it up. It is totally up to you.
You want to run? We got a lot of space.
All right, me and Olivia are going to run back and forth. So if you got a good lengthy living room basement, run the length of that back and forth.
We're on. Let's hit it for 30 seconds in 3, 2, 1.
Woo!
It's harder to watch the clock. Keep it up, guys.
More to go.
My hands. My heart rate's getting elevated.
My hands.
Oh. Good morning, Rach. Welcome in. Sarah getting some good ideas for later. Hey, Jesse.
We're gonna be back on in about 5 seconds. What do you wanna do? Jumping jacks. 30 seconds. 3, 2, 1, let's go.
My socializing is getting in the way of my workout.
Let's go, final 10 seconds.
Yeah.
One more round. Yeah, one more. What do you want to do?
jump lunges?
No. Jump squats?
Jump squats?
Jump
okay.
squats.
Jump squats. Woo! 10 more seconds to rest. In
3, 2, 1.
Your last 30. If you're working jump squats right now, absorbing your landing, catch yourself on soft knees, rebound right back to the top. If you don't like the jump, work a heel raise. That's half.
Last two.
Woo!
Good work. We're gonna cover 90 seconds. Woo! Get a drink.
Your final block is going to be an 8-minute row focus block. We'll see your word of the day, your challenge, and then we'll work some flexibility. So we're definitely on the second half of today. Yeah, I'll talk through. Aaron's gonna demo this block.
Since your coaches are out of breath right now, we can't multitask.
So we're looking for two weights if you have them, to objects of the same weight or pretty close to it. Your first movement, 8 reps, good morning to a tricep kickback. So you can start with her elbows at a 90 degree bend, shoulders away from the ears. It's a hinge at the hips. Once she's got the flat back position, tricep kickback to the 90 degree, stand tall on every single rep. So that's 1 rep for you. An option here would be a lighter object or just work your body weight. Next movement, hip hinge, low row. She's gonna set herself up at the bottom of the hip hinge. Arms are extended, drawing elbows back alongside the body. Pinch between the shoulder blades, press the dumbbells towards the floor. We're gonna work 8 reps on that movement. Next, she's turning into a sumo squat to an upright row. So feet are always wider than the hips, toes are angled out. Dumbbells face your body or your object. Sit down and back into the squat. Elbows go wide, dumbbells to the armpits. Option here. If you do have shoulder issues, you can work just the sumo squat. Take out that upright row. Final movement is going to be core focus. Watch your head. It's going to be your crunch. So she's elevating her shoulders, then she has scissor kicks here. 16 in total. An option here would be putting a bend in your knees, tapping heels to the floor to take pressure off your low back. So we do have 8 minutes on your work. 8 reps through the first 3, 16 in total on the core. Does anybody have questions? I don't know. Hello, hello, welcome in. All right, you ready?
Ready.
I don't think we have any questions, so we'll roll for 8 minutes. Woo!
3, 2, 1. Again, good morning kickbacks. 90 degree bend, hinging over, back is flat. Drive those dumbbells straight back, right to that starting position, stand up. Whew, last few. One more. All right, that hip hinge low row. Whew.
All right, so shoulders start away from your ears, feet hip width apart, pushing hips back into the hip hinge. So that next movement is going to be your sumo squat to upright row. Again, feet wider than your hips, toes angled out. We'll sit down and back into the squat. Three. rest few. Alright, so getting out your mat, whatever you need.
That static crunch with your scissors. Anchor that spine down, lift the shoulder blades, soft fingertips right behind the head. Bringing those feet up and down. 16 total. Again, option that slight bend through your knees, tapping those heels to the floor.
That's right. So maybe that first round through, if you're not working with real dumbbells, you're not finding the challenge, you can always adjust your tempo at which you're working. That tempo is time under tension. It's another way to find resistance. So slow your work if you're looking for more resistance. Pressure in your low back, put a little bit more of a bend in your knees. It's gonna soften the pressure on your back.
Chest stays lifted. Crunch with your scissors, down back on the floor. Woo! Lift those shoulder blades. I did 20 total that first time.
Yeah, I did more than 16. If you need to, you can grab a drink of water. I know I am.
We are a little about 2.5 minutes out still. We can make it through one more round.
Absolutely.
One more round.
Arms start to get that 90 degree bend. Push your hips back. The tricep extension. Oh yeah, last one. Whew. Hip hinge low row.
Point those toes out. Woo, here we go.
I guess sitting down and back on the way to the top, driving knees out. It's like you're pushing into the corner of the room here. right, guys, last 16 reps on the block.
So if you have to get your morning started, go ahead and stretch it out. For those that you want to stay, we have our extra credit of the day.
Yeah.
Our word of the day is more life. So, whoo, we got 8 different movements we're going to work through. Starting with 20 lunges, 20 push-ups. We'll have 15 burpees with a shoulder tap, 15 squats, a 1-minute plank, 20 alternating lunges, a 1-minute squat hold, and then finishing with 15 more squats. So.
I'm up for it.
I'm up for it.
Give us a wave if you're up for it, if you're in for that more life challenge.
Get it done under 5 minutes or less.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Woo. Finish off today's workout.
Woo. There we go. There we go.
It is 2 words, Josh.
It is 2 words. Double extra credit, Josh.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Awesome. All right, guys. We'll get it rolling. We're starting with your M. Whew. We're working into your alternating lunge. 20 reps total. Your chest stays lifted. We're gonna step back behind. Knee comes to a 90 degree bend. Press firmly through your forward foot. We're gonna work 20 reps in 3, 2, 1. Final few.
Woo! Did I just count?
I don't know.
Okay. Gosh, I cannot count today.
Neither can I. So you're oh. Man. Woo! Yeah, we haven't had any push-ups today, so we might as well add them in. All right. So your push-up, palms a little bit wider than your shoulder width apart. Your feet are about hip width apart, wider stance, more stability. Your core is tight. We're driving elbows back behind us. Exhale, press through the floor. Option there from your knees. Let's work in for 20. Let's see how many we can do from our toes.
Third there. Yeah, we are.
10.
Last 5. Shake it out. Your E, it's 15 squats.
I think we're pros by squats.
Oh yeah.
Pros ass squats.
All right, guys.
I know.
Let's wrap it out. 15 of them. 3, 2, 1.
Sometimes, but just gotta get through it.
Absolutely.
One day at a time.
Whew. One coronavirus workout at a time.
That's right. That's right.
So you're 1 minute blank.
I gotta stop watch.
You ready? Are you guys ready?
1 minute plank. Hold in 3, 2, 1. Let's get down.
Shoulders over elbows. If you do have shoulder issues, take it to your palms. You can always work from your knees.
That wider base with your feet also helps stabilize that core.
Squeeze your glutes to engage your core. Squeeze them.
Woo! We are halfway. 30 seconds.
Keep it up.
Don't drop.
Nope.
Don't drop. If you drop, get right back up. Find that control in your breathing. Your last 20 seconds. We're there in 3, 2, 1. Let's drop. No joke.
Not at all. All right, we're looking at 20 reps, your lateral lunge. So on this movement, you're gonna step wide, pressing your weight through the outside of your foot, back behind you. We'll move through the midline, alternating out on your reps. Keep your shoulders down and away from your ears. It's 20 reps. Let's go to it in 3, 2, 1.
Last couple reps. There it is.
All right, guys.
Two more movements.
It's a squat hold for 60 and then right into 15 squats.
No break, just get right into it.
Yeah,
let's do it. Let's just get it done. We're just gonna get it done.
That'll be a killer burner.
Yeah.
But let's have some fun with it.
Ready?
Yeah, I'm ready.
3, 2, 1, let's go.
Sitting down and back into your heels, shoulders away from your ears. If you need, you can always come out of that squat, but get right back to it. Whew.
That's halfway, 30 seconds.
Let's work it, Cottleville, keep it up.
Again, right after this last 30 seconds, you're going to go right into 15 bodyweight squats. Just pulsing it out. 15 seconds.
Whew. Working into that final bit. It's like your last all out of your class. Let's treat it like that. Strong all the way to your finish line.
15 squats in 3, 2, 1. Let's get there. Woo! Last few. Come on. For everybody. Whew. Let's go ahead and stretch it out.
Yeah. Whew. All right, arms coming up and over. Rounding out through your shoulders. Whew. Let's pull up and over to one side. Just find a nice stretch through your lat, through the side of your body, through your obliques. You can tip into it a little bit. Whew. That got my heart rate up, that's for sure.
Oh, yeah.
Let's go ahead and switch sides.
And I started my wash today.
I missed the first.
Official workout.
I missed the first Woo! Two blocks. Oh, I talked about it.
Right? I hate when I forget.
Yeah. Whew. Huh. Let's shake it out. Let's put one arm across the body.
Okay.
Your shoulder drop down and away. Catch across your body.
So if you do not have a heart rate monitor and you're looking to use it at a studio workout, we do have heart rate monitors on sale right now. They're $20 off and we have a brand new core one that just came in. So again, message me, Olivia Cottleville's page. We can get you more information about that. So you get those summaries, get those flat points, track every single workout that you're doing at home. So
absolutely.
Keep you accountable.
Yeah.
Switch up those arms if you haven't.
I always forget.
Yeah, I always forget too. I think I did.
If you do have that text phone number for the studio, you can always text that. We have that, we're checking that often, so you can shoot us a text.
See those quads?
Yeah.
Let's go ahead, grab one leg, bring it right behind you, hold on to a wall. Anything nearby if you don't have that balance right now.
I just touch my nose. Touch your nose, tug an ear, whatever you need.
Go, so legs up. Go get that nose, girl.
I know. Grab a seat on the floor.
Yeah. Have a seat. Ooh. Last couple stretches right here. Bring those feet out in front of you. Reach for those toes. Put a nice round through that back, lower back, back of those calves, hamstrings, posterior chain. All right, guys.
Ooh, we'll bring it in. Drop any questions that you might have. I'm gonna keep us this way, actually.
Okay, keep us okay. That way.
Jamie, it was good to have you this morning.
Hi, Jamie.
Sarah, hey, what's going on? Courtney? Britt? Reporters? Whew. Amy, good morning. So tomorrow, we're gonna host a coaches chat. So if you guys aren't doing anything in the afternoon, it's actually gonna be a Zoom call. So you'll see a link on the Cottleville page at some point in time. So if you're just looking to hang out, chat, maybe you have questions, maybe you just wanna talk to other Orange Theory members, talk to your coaches, we'll be doing that tomorrow afternoon. So make sure you check back on the Cottleville story for more details on that. Again, like Erin said, yeah. We've got those heart rate monitors. We'll be here 9 a.m. Thank you.
Without phone difficulties next
yeah,
time, hopefully.
Yeah. Sorry we were tardy today.
I think that's it.
All right, guys.
Have a great Tuesday.
Yeah, we'll see you tomorrow. Have a good one.
Bye, guys.
Bye.